Hey guys, your boy Grippers, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool career mode. We're last and left off. We began season 4 with a bang. Especially with 2 wins starting me off, well, in the usual fashion. And a big change to the team, which, I mean, it's not even worth my time trying to hide it. If you didn't see the last episode, you see it straight away. Lloris Karius wanted to leave. He wasn't going to sign a new contract, so I acted quickly. Got in. He meant Thibaut Courtois. So, yeah.
Hello once again, I'm Martin Tyler, and
pretty pleased with my summer window dealings. Of course, the window hasn't closed. In fact, this match is taking place on deadline.
This team has started like champions, haven't they? We all expected them to be at the end of it, but 2 wins out of 2, they've certainly announced their intentions to the rest of the teams in this division.
Liverpool hoping that they can reach the same heights again as they did in their away win against West Bromwich Albion.
Oh, 4-0. The manager would have been delighted.
At
the end of today as well.
No more departures or arrivals.
Italy with Inter. There was a lot expected of him. He didn't quite live up to expectations
for the club.
He moved on.
He's so
because
Clever player,
to bring in anyone. My team is perfect the way it is.
This is the Liverpool side. Thibaut Courtois starts in goal. David Alaba starts.
Everyone is contracted.
Renato Sanchez in central midfield. In attack, Divock Origi starts. He was man of the match last time out. Here is the Norwich City team for you today. Russell Martin starts with Ryan Bennett in central defence.
Angle 3-3.
Who's shown poor form lately. Eduardo Vargas is the main
starter
today.
That'll be a perfect start.
Moving away, trying to find room for a shot maybe.
Season.
There's the ball in.
And it'll be a good way to round off August.
The away team come here having drawn their last 2 games, which shows a competitive streak.
Still the loom.
No, that's our. Whether a draw here would be satisfactory, whether they take that now.
And the keeper can collect.
We're of a deadline day. Like I said.
Great interception.
Hopefully, I'll be going through it very quickly. I shouldn't get any interruptions. I think I've said so. My players can't be bidded for. I think so, anyway.
This is how they
I normally do that really quick, early into a season. Players. I don't intend to sell. I can't even be asked.
Good thing about these pitches these days.
Pretend I'm interested.
Here, it just goes straight through.
It does, and
that's all I do. I pretend I'm interested.
The surface, and that's great for attacking quick play.
Now, depending on the amount and the player,
somehow he saved it.
A bit might catch my eye, but most of the time I'll say, nah, I don't expect to keep hold of this player throughout the career mode.
Well, they've been thwarted here. That's a sign of better things to come.
I mean, I could have gotten a better keeper. Karius was only 82 when this career mode started. I could have gotten a better
keeper. Could be dangerous.
But I wanted to give Karius a chance.
Gets his foot in there.
And for 3 seasons, he was very good.
Oh, he's true.
He went up to an 87 rating all over that time. And
there's a chance playing at home to extend this.
In the whole time he was my goalkeeper, he made one mistake.
Previous two, I could see them making it as well.
Really good, actually. Although I did say if he had made that mistake, if he ever made the mistake again, I
looking good this move.
Have sold him or
he's had to go full.
He would have been exiled from the team. It was a bad. You guys remember it?
News of a goal from West Ham.
It's a goal from Manchester City.
Another shot.
If anyone seen the channel for a bit, it would have seen that episode.
To need to interrupt.
If you're new to
we've got the news really from it. And here comes the counter attack.
Channel, I would recommend that as one of the go-to episodes in the series because I lost. I was seeing red. I was seeing red. And I don't mean the jerseys.
Plenty of action at White Hart Lane today.
I was completely
41 minutes played.
PO'd. Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual. He'll need to try and get the ball back.
Thankfully,
Dele Alli.
He didn't make that mistake again, and now he's gone off to Chelsea. And I have Courtois.
Well, only two more minutes to be added on by the referee now. Onto the attack now. This could be it.
Ali Origi!
Goal, they're in front.
It took three games, but I think that's his first goal of the season for Dele Alli.
Well, they're celebrating Liverpool.
Yeah, it is.
Not just the nature of the goal, but the timing of it.
Yeah, I think so. There's nothing better just before half-time. You go in, you're happy, and you're ready to go for that second.
There's confirmation.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
His first...
That's half-time. Signaled by the referee.
Oh, scored by himself. I should specify, because he already has a few assists. In the previous two games.
Well, the rain has continued through half-time, and it is relentless. This pitch can only take so much more water.
Origi is off and running, which means that the top goal scorer race is going to get that little bit more interesting.
And a cheeky flick finish past the keeper. 46 minutes played.
Coutinho! The keeper might be needed again. He didn't have it to the book.
Hey!
Terrific stop!
Ooh.
You'd expect him to save that, and he did save it. Apologies for interrupting Alan McAnally a moment or two ago. Chelsea did score. The score is now 2-0. Youssouf Malumbu. Substitute coming up for the away team.
In about half a season, Whitney. He at the end of last season,
the opposition can't get
about
them.
Five goals. He already has Coutinho. Two this season, so probably on course to.
That deal has been completed now.
Meh. Real Madrid have made if the not better, is a goal scoring record in a Liverpool shirt.
Isn't a small
Sadio Mane.
Wide of the post.
He'll have to put in some work if he's done at his best.
Activity on the bench for the losing team. A substitute getting ready to come on. Divock Origi.
Divock Origi.
Good place to win the ball back there because the pressure was starting to mount. And the interception was timely to say the least. Challenges for the ball. We see a substitute coming on for the away team here. Well, this attack has got a bit of menace to it.
Come on.
And here's the cross. Cut out by the defender.
Roberto Firmino.
Just a heavy touch, the opposition could take the ball away.
Cleared away.
Quick
pressure.
Your diary, make a note of this particular date. EA Sports, we've got the presentation of the Premier League fixture. Liverpool, they'll be facing Aston Villa away from home.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Oh, shit! Good save from Courtois after I missed the challenge with Sewell. now the chance for a counter attack. Sadio Mane. He crosses the line. Firmino, 2-0.
It's a big moment for them in the match. They've
get in.
Their lead now to 2 ahead. They played well to this.
That is the deadliness of my counter attack. Just so much pace up front.
It is certainly.
It's hard for any defense to deal with.
See. The better team playing the better football.
That's why when a team attacks me, they need to deal the death blow. They have to pound the nail in. They can't miss. First goal of the season for Roberto Firmino.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. So we're coming down now towards the last.
And that second goal really puts Norwich now in desperate need of
Divock Origi.
Well, a miracle.
And the away team want to make a change. Oh, he's totally, totally done the defender. Vargas. They should win now, shouldn't they? 2-0 here, not much time to go. What impact will that have on the next game?
Well, Liverpool go up against Aston Villa.
It's probably going to be a
referee sees that
foul, yeah.
It's a foul, and it is a free kick.
Yeah, I didn't think it was going to be a hard.
Part in the game into
so just
really.
A talk.
Well, it was badly timed. He didn't get the ball.
There's another situation
he
where.
Committed a foul there.
A real error by the keeper. Now it's 5 minutes to go.
Get him on the counter here.
Divock Origi.
Origi.
Well here.
Coutinho! Wraps it up in style.
For the main chance. Oh.
The captain deals the final blow. Oh, and delivers all 3 points to the Reds.
And left the goal gaping. Well, it was
an
easy goal in the end. The kind that you wouldn't expect to get at this level.
See, another situation where the Reds just had too much pace for Norwich to deal with. If Coutinho scores his first goal of the season.
Given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
Players. In fact,
referee's had a good look.
All my midfielders have at least one goal. And all my
to add on 3 minutes.
He attack and my main strikers.
Nicely played through ball.
Scored one goal in this game as well.
That's his game, isn't it? Intercepting.
So
good work by the goalkeeper. Final whistle from the referee. Liverpool
after three games,
a different kind of game to the one perhaps we set up for you at the beginning.
About half the team have a goal in the Premier League. Over half the team. The only outfielders who don't have goals in the Premier League yet are the defenders. Hers. I mean, actually, no, Alaba scored in the last episode, so it's only my two center backs, Sula and
Norwich City, 0. Manchester United, 2.
And Joel,
0.
And Nathaniel Clyne.
Newcastle United, 0. Bournemouth,
I mean, Nathaniel Clyne hasn't scored since the first
West Ham
season,
United,
so maybe he's overdue for
let's
one.
Let's take a look at what those results mean to the league table. At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 9 points. In second, Chelsea with 7 points. In third, Bournemouth with 7 points. In
fourth,
Manchester City with 6 points.
Dwarf.
In fifth, Sunderland.
Oh, I must not have put a thing
in
on
sixth,
here.
Swansea City with 4 points.
Probably not going to sell him, so I'm just going to reject. In 8th,
Manchester United with 4 points. Bottom of the table, West Bromwich Albion with no points. And then reading up the table, I mean, second bottom, Everton with no points.
And no real interest in signing.
Crystal Palace with no points. Fourth bottom, Newcastle United with 1 point. Fifth bottom, Southampton with 1 point.
Bid for Joe Gomez. I was thinking I would listen to an offer for him. That's how much I want. Let's see what Inter Milan say. Will they be interested in doing this deal or no? I mean, they need to decide quickly or they're gonna run out of time. It's no scam. Hey, he knows I got my options ready to go for the season. Looks like I'm not gonna hear back from them. Even if they come in now, they're gonna run out of time. Wow, what one? Holy shit! Wait, what? Are you fucking mad? I mean, even if I accept it, you have no time to get the deal done. 22 million. I'm not gonna lie. I think I would have accepted 22 million. But they're not gonna have time to do it. They're not gonna have time to get the deal done. And I'll accept it. They have 1 hour. Good luck with that. I mean, that would be enough time. In real life, you could probably get an extension, but I don't think that's how it works in game. But Man United spent 94.5 million on Ross Barkley. Of all the players, you spent 90+ million on. You spent that money on Barkley. Don't get me wrong, Barkley's good, but he's not worth more than 30 million on his best day. As you're never going to be replaced. You're the heartbeat of this team. Forget what I'm looking for here. Oh wow, look at this guy's name. Would you believe it? Xander Peters. He has an extra E though. It's probably said differently, but sure enough, that's his name. Arthur Williams. I actually have completely forgot what I'm supposed to be looking, what I sent this guy's out for. But, hey, no injuries, so, yeah, all is good over here. Take out Cabela and Fayor, because they are, I think they must have recently gone up. And Berg could, go up to 75. And, Oh, wow. Both the, young center backs are really close. Let's get, this guy up first. He can go up to a 79. He was a little closer than his, center back. Cohort, if that's the right word I'm looking for, probably not. Well, hey, I mean, thanks for the thing on Donnarumma. Yeah, it's too late, but thanks anyway. Did my thing just go down to 81? I still don't understand why it keeps just deducting it. Could... Shiojo, I wonder if ball control going up to 75 will be enough to get him to an A rate. Cox could go up here, so could Moya. Probably not the center back. Still don't know how to say his name. really? Nope. Moya and Cox did go up. Osho didn't even go up in ball control. Oh, sorry. It was going to go up to 74. But, yeah, Cox and Moya can come out in the next training session. It did go down to 81 for what reason, I don't know. Czech Republic, not interested at all, ever. Sorry, David, Nathaniel Klein is still the main right back. Ring is cover 81. May not be too much longer, and Nathaniel will be slowly faded out, but I don't think I'll be able to play a lot longer. I like Nathaniel in there. It was a more her current feel. Track. That was the thing for this season, this year's FIFA, was to use as many Liverpool players as possible. I still have a majority of current Liverpool talent: Sadio Mane, Diogo Garrigi, Coutinho, Firmino, Matip, and Klein. Many have moved on, many were not good enough, and I replaced them. Karius would have been in that, would have been part of the current set of players for Liverpool, but he decided he wanted to move on. And yes, I do count Karius, even though Mignolet is currently in goal on a regular basis.
Hi there, everybody. Welcome to the city of Birmingham, to the football ground of Aston Villa, Villa Park. And Alan Smith, who knows these parts of the world very well indeed, is smiling away, delighted to be here. The Aston Villa team for this game.
Richie
Delatt in the fullback positions. Jack Grealish starts. He was man of the match in his last game. It's good to see them going
early
with two strikers today.
From the Liverpool side, Thibaut Courtois starts in goal.
Ooh! Two good teams, aren't they?
Cora had to get
third. Still fairly on in the season, but
body in the way
to themselves to be still there.
Matip!
Matip! Ooh!
That's cleared out of play. It'll be a corner.
John must have heard me talking about him not having a goal yet this season. So, and Matip is out on. It's onside. Matip has erased his name off the list, and that'll actually probably go down as a Nicholas Sewell assist. Because it was him who entered it that direction.
And that's not what you want from your goalkeeper, and it's cost his soul.
Joe Matip at the back post. The centre backs are freaking conspiring against me. Joe Matip, fair play to you.
The first goal is
fair play. So it's just Sewell and Klein who have of the main team who have not scored
tackle goes
in the Premier League. We're only in game four.
Attacking well here.
Oh, they just ripped me apart.
It's always thrilling when both teams...
I mean, Sue missed the challenge, and then this Martinez guy just fucking ran past him.
The game is
players like they weren't there.
So,
who the fuck is this dude?
Made the challenge well.
Okay. Hey, no. Fuck off. I'll take a yellow card. Now this guy is going to be a problem.
Here, the referee not ducking the issue, but this player's now walking a tightrope for the rest of the game.
Well, he's just going to have to watch himself and the style of footballer that he is. He doesn't normally pull out a tackle, so he's going to have to be careful.
Sadio Mane.
That'll be a throw.
Ah! Accidentally running out of play. Great.
Good position. Wow. They've worked this attack very well. To a quite a dangerous position.
Good defensive work. Damn it. You up?
Roberto Firmino.
Go on, Roberto. Yes, Bobby. Yes, Bobby. Ah!
A tackle and a half.
No.
Martinez.
Shit. Moron, he passed it off instead of going himself.
The approach play looked very encouraging.
If it had any sense, they'd get the ball to him as much as possible. I'd say, dude, just run with it.
Challenges for the ball. Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped. Tackling, it's a real skill.
Origi!
By the standards of this game, that was a great chance.
He's never going to be a match of lots of scoring opportunities, and he might live to regret that one.
Ah. Oh!
Oh, mistake by the goalkeeper.
The keeper makes a mistake, and he gives Origi a response. In front now. After the miss, the keeper stupidly gives Steve O'Gurry.
Well, that has to go down to the
a makeup chance.
Gonna be good footballers.
As if to say, hey, he clearly should have scored that. I mean, that was just an unlucky miss. Here you go, have another go. I mean, what sense does that make?
Aston Villa behind now. Sanchez. Micah Richards. Richie Delatt. Tried to tackle here and he's done that. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Now he's got the hunger. It's Renato Sanchez with the ball and it's in the back of the net.
They lead by two.
Quick fire double. Renato Sanchez makes it 3-1.
For this advantage at the moment. Goalkeeper was reaching for it, and it did actually touch him on the way in.
I think there was just too much power.
Making it hard for me to shoot with Sadio Mane, so he decided to pass to Renato Sanchez. Well, they closed him off. I thought, you know, if I get the shot away, maybe the keeper will save it and put it out for a corner. No, instead, the ball goes back into the back of the net, and he scores his second of the season.
3-1 the scoreline as we restart.
In his first season, he scored 7 goals. So that. So that's,
A lot of newspaper inches.
So if he has any goal this
particular
season,
manager and the temptation of an international job, but we understand that he's turned that down.
Yeah, well, better.
Maybe he's got other irons in the fire. Only he could tell you that. He doesn't see it as the job for him.
Very good first season.
Whether that's going to be the case in the future, I don't know, because I think most managers, they are their ambitions, don't they?
Coutinho. The job that he. Into Dele Alli, who puts it over the bar.
Otherwise, we'd have been talking about one of the goals of the season.
Well, they cut through the defence on the breakaway, and all it needed was a composed head at the end.
Here's Alli. Now they've got a. Oh, he could be in.
Mane. Can Alli get there? can't do that.
Well, did he not score a goal at any point in a game? He hasn't really looked like scoring any so far, has he?
It's not. We'll be hoping for Wardo as the match develops. Or Wardo.
Well, the defenders will be pleased to see.
Worry about
for it with a fist.
I'm felt a soul.
Possibility.
Dele Alli.
He's kept it out.
Was pulling off all the saves. Stop pulling off all the saves. He's dick war.
And he bangs it away. That's half time now.
Half time. 3-1.
Well, time is ticking away. It's time for a change, and here it comes. It's Liverpool's game to win, really. Now they've got the lead at half time. Off they go for the second half.
Cut this game.
Through pass.
Come off as a competition in the second half. Firmino, penalty.
He cleared that really well.
Oh, piss off, ref. Piss off.
Looking for an opening with some good controlled build up. And they're stopped in their tracks by a raised flag.
Yeah, I hit it only because I saw the linesman flag.
No.
Where was your flag when he fouled me in the box? Huh? Huh? Nowhere? Oh, that's good.
The ball away there, literally to the opposition.
Fucking left it home, did ya? In your fucking, in the space between that and the off. Sorry, you remembered. Oh, I better go get that.
He's coming forward with some
fucking
danger.
Wank.
Corner now for Liverpool. And here's the header.
Ooh!
Good save.
So close. It was actually a soul as well.
Coming onto the pitch.
May have only been dipping onto the crossbar, but it was dipping.
And in
couldn't
the
take
cross.
The chance.
And in comes
Sanchez! Oh!
Could make a chance with this tackle.
Origi. Putting the challenge, but it went straight to her.
Half an hour to go. They could have got through there, but the defender was absolutely on top of his game. He went in well.
Daniel Klein. Making a
here's
run.
A chance to attack.
Go on, Nathaniel. Go on, Nathaniel. Oh!
Great work by the
go. No, he's passed it back into Coutinho.
Brilliant goalkeeping. Short passes.
Firmino.
Keeping the ball. And there is some backup for him in this position.
Sanchez. Someone was offside, I think. And I think they're letting play go on. Nathaniel!
That's great work by the goalkeeper.
Oh, where if he had left for... he hasn't scored since... I think it was the Sun...
Attacking power in this situation.
The Sun or Crystal Palace.
To cross it now.
One of those two teams.
There's the ball in.
It was like a...
And he headed it goalwards.
No, I think it was Crystal Palace because it was a team you used to play for. So it's either Palace or Southampton.
Didn't he get it right?
Was some...
The plotting of the trajectory as the ball came in and the contact with.
Now I'm thinking it's one of three teams.
When you can jump like
I'd have to go back and watch that, but
very hard to stop.
Wasn't Man United? Where did that just pop in my head?
So we restart again, 4-1.
In the 19.
Jordan Veretout.
Like I said, I have to go back in now. Watch, I know he it would be his first goal since then. He didn't score one in season 2, and he didn't score one in season 3.
Attacking third. Looking to play his teammate through. They were hoping, but it didn't lead to anything, the cross. And we have 9 remaining minutes. So not much time left at all. What did this mean, Alan, for the next game?
Yeah, Aston Villa go up against Swansea City after this.
Should I cut back there?
To do better because they've been so poor.
Maybe.
And the cross comes in now.
Oh, Coutinho! 5-1.
A little Brazilian, but Coutinho has always got an eye for the main chance.
Great stuff. Great stuff.
And Liverpool have got the goal.
The game is well and truly over.
Easy to finish.
Defenders caught out by it in the end.
Oh, it's a brilliant header.
Goal score here.
Remember, it's weird. Five goals. You know, no one's really making themselves the clear man of the match.
It's not a problem for this team, is it?
No, I think their manager will be delighted because they've not taken it easily at all. They've given respect to their opponents, but they've shown their class too.
Substitution for Aston Villa coming off the
bench. I'm trying to think. Have all five goals been scored by five different players?
Referee's had a good look and decided what he's seen from this period of play to add on 3 minutes. On to the attack now.
We have Matip.
And Villa could be in here.
Renato Sanchez, Mane, Ali. Origi and Coutinho. Yeah, it is. Five different guys. Five goals, five different scores. I know I didn't get the exact order right, but I was trying to think of their names off. The name. Josef Alexander Martinez. I've never even fucking heard of you. But you were clearly on something. Either that or Villa found the fucking rebirth of Aubameyang.
Aston Villa.
Or the fucking love child of Aubameyang and Usain Bolt.
Two.
Who is somehow not Everton an African American, which is odd considering both
City one
men
Chelsea
are of that complexion.
Tottenham Hotspur two.
You know, I know they're not near our American. I don't know.
West Bromwich Albion two.
I mean,
Swansea City nil.
Is Aubameyang an African? In German? I don't know. At the top of the table, is that even a thing? Liverpool probably not.
With 12 points. In second, Bournemouth with 10 points. In third, Chelsea with 8 points.
What?
In fourth, Swansea City with
7 points. What are you talking about? He's only got one yellow card. That was the first yellow of the season.
Aston Villa with 7
points. What are you talking about?
In seventh, Manchester City with 6 points. In eighth, Arsenal with 6 points. Bottom of the table, Newcastle United with 1 point. And then reading up the table, second bottom.
What are you at?
With 1 point.
What? What are you?
Norwich City with 2.
You can't carry over cards from last season? Or.
Fifth bottom, Leicester City with 2.
I have no idea what the hell is going on. How is. What? I'm completely fucking stumped. I'll try and figure this out. Oh, I mean, I don't think there's anything I can do about it. Dele Alli will miss the next league game, which will take place after this game against PSV. Oh, wow. That's a really good group. Ooh, that's probably the easiest group I've gotten so far, maybe. Schalke, PSV and Roma. No offense to those three teams, but you know, still wouldn't think that's, you know, it's no group of death. Considering the teams I could have gotten. Oh, I mean, I could be in Man City's group with Real Madrid. In fact, other than Real Madrid, that's not really a bad group. I mean, Monaco, yeah, they knocked out Man City in real life. And Besiktas, that's Liverpool. There's a Liverpool fan I know who Besiktas are not to be underestimated. Atletico Madrid, Benfica, Feyenoord, no easy match there for Chelsea. Spurs. Hang on. Spurs. United. There's five Premier League teams. Wait, what? How are there five? Oh, wait. I know. No, wait, Spurs for a second. I was going to say that Spurs are in there because they won the Europa League. I know this because I played, because the Super Cup game was against them. Maybe it gave the fifth spot, which was Manchester United, the Spurs' place in the Champions League, because Spurs had two qualifications. I don't know. That's the only thing I can think of. I'm not going to put too much thought into it. I am, however, going to say, hey, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. Well, and until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.